interest rate parity, IRP. It is defined as the difference in interest rates between two countries is equal to the percentage difference between the forward exchange rate and the spot exchange rate. Let me give an example of how this definition should be understood. For example, if Japan's interest rate is 4% higher than the US interest rate, then the forward rate should be 4% higher than the current spot rate as well. Otherwise, there is an arbitrage opportunity. Arbitrage means making guaranteed profit without taking any risk. So it's probably still pretty confusing what this whole interest rate parity is about. Let me explain it using the following example. Let's say you have $1. There are two things you could do with your $1. One, you could invest it domestically. Two, you could invest it, let's say, in Japan. Let's look at the option number one. You want to invest it domestically within the United States. You want to make a risk-free investment with a guaranteed return after 1 year. What is the name of like a risk-free asset in this country? It's basically, you know, the short-term government bond called treasury bill, and the return you would get on it is known as the risk-free rate. So let's say the risk-free rate on such short-term government bond in the United States is 4%. So the notation we use for the risk-free rate in the United States is capital R subscript USA, and that's 4%. That's one thing you can do to get your guaranteed 4% return on your $1. Instead, you could use your $1 and invest it overseas. And again, you want to make a very safe investment that will bring you a guaranteed return. It should be a risk-free investment. So whatever the name of the Japanese government's short-term bond is, that's the risk-free asset you would buy in Japan for 1 year. And let's say the risk-free rate there is 6%. So capital R subscript Japan equals 6%. 4% here, 6% there. One more thing we know in this example is that the current spot exchange rate is S0 equals 120 yen per $1. The question in this problem is, under which condition will you be indifferent between the two investments? Okay, so the question may sound very vague and kind of unclear what needs to be done. So let's see, you know, let's kind of dig a bit deeper and do some math. How much are we going to have from today's $1 after 1 year? Well, if we invest $1 into the US risk-free asset with the return of 4%, then in 1 year, this $1 investment will grow to $1 times 1 plus the interest rate, RUSA, which equals $1 times 1 plus 0.04 in decimals, which gives $1.04, right? It's basically, you know, the future value calculations. You could also do it in the financial calculator, where $1 would be your PV, changed to a negative number, N would be 1 because we want to find the value after 1 year. IY would be the return. You would put 4 and you would be computing FV. And the calculator will give you 1.04 as the answer. So that's how much you will have after 1 year from today's $1 if this $1 is invested domestically into the risk-free asset that brings a guaranteed 4% return. The second option was you instead invest your $1 into the Japan's risk-free asset equivalent. The return on the Japan's risk-free asset is 6%. Okay, well, first of all, we are kind of not really investing dollars in Japan. We should be investing yen. If you have $1 to invest yen, we need to first convert it into yen. What do we use for the conversion? Today's exchange rate, the spot exchange rate, which was given, right? 120 yen per $1. So $1 is multiplied by 120 yen per $1, which gives 120 yen. So really, you're investing 120 yen into the Japanese financial market. And now we want to do a similar math. In 1 year, this investment will grow to 120 yen times 1 plus 0.06, the return that's guaranteed after 1 year, which gives 127.2 Japanese yen. And then we want to compare apples with apples. So what does it mean in terms of dollars, right? So we can then compare, the value of this investment to what you would get if you instead invested your money in the United States, right? So we want to go back from yen to dollars, right? In 1 year, 127.2 yen will be exchanged back into dollars. How? So what is the name of the exchange rate that we can already know today, that we know today already, that will be used in 1 year to convert one currency into another? What was the name of such trade where we know what exchange rate will be used at some point of time in the future? That's the forward exchange rate, the 1 year forward exchange rate, agreed upon today. So whatever that rate is that is already known today, that would be used to exchange yen into dollars in 1 year, that's what we would need to use to convert next year's 127.2 yen back into dollars. So in terms of dollars, this investment made in Japan will be worth this much money in dollars, right? So it will be worth 127.2 yen divided by the 1 year forward. And 1 year forward will be expressed as how many yen it is per dollar, right? So you would divide next year's yen by yen per dollar, and you will be left with dollars, the dollar amount, right? And now let's summarize our results. So if you invest your $1 in the US risk-free asset at 4%, you will have $1.04. If you instead invest your $1 into Japan's risk-free asset at 6%, then in 1 year, in terms of dollars, you will have 127.2 yen divided by the 1 year forward rate. So whatever that ratio gives you, that's how much your investment will be worth in dollars when it's made in Japan. And now we can answer the main question in this problem, which was, under which circumstances would you be indifferent between the two investments? What does being indifferent between the two investments really mean? It means you don't care whether your $1 is invested in the United States or in Japan. What does it mean you don't care? In which case would you not care? Well, if you make the same money in 1 year, right? So how much money are we talking about in 1 year? We already have it for option number one, $1.04. We kind of don't have it yet for option number two. It's not very clear because we don't know what F1 is, the 1 year forward rate. But what we are basically saying is that regardless of whether your $1 is invested here or there, either way, it should give you $1.04 in 1 year. So you must make the same money, $1.04, in both the USA and in Japan. And we can now calculate in which case this will be true. What is our unknown? The F1 for the value of the investment in Japan. So $1.04, that's in 1 year in the United States, must equal 127.2 yen divided by the 1 year forward rate. And then we rearrange to solve for the 1 year forward rate. The 1 year forward rate should be 127.2 divided by 1.01, which gives 122.3 yen per dollar. This is the condition under which we will be indifferent between whether our $1 is invested in the United States or in Japan. The 1 year forward rate must be exactly 122.3 for us to be indifferent between the two countries' investments. If the 1 year forward rate is actually not that number, it's not 122.3 but something else, then we again have what we, you know, kind of keep coming back to when we learn every new formula in this chapter. We will have an opportunity to make profit, a guaranteed profit. In other words, an arbitrage opportunity. In this particular context with the interest rates, it's called a covered interest arbitrage. Let me go back by one slide and give you an example. Let's say the 1 year forward rate is not 122.3, but only 121. So it's less than it should be. If it's only 121, less than it should be, which country are you going to prefer? Are you going to want to invest in the United States or in Japan? Well, mathematically, if you look at where the 1 year forward rate makes a difference, it makes a difference for the investment made in Japan. So mathematically, if we divide 127.2 yen by a smaller number, we are going to get a bigger number as a result, which would mean that everybody would want to invest their money in Japan, where they would make more money after 1 year, rather than in the United States. That's if the forward rate is lower than what it should be for that indifference between the two countries. So lower than 122.3, such as, for example, 121 yen per dollar. And the other way around, what if the 1 year forward rate is higher than how high it should be? So let's say it's 125 yen per dollar. Then mathematically, for Japan, when we divide by a larger number, we get a smaller answer. Smaller means we will make less than $1.04 if we invest our money in Japan. So where would all investors be investing their money into? Not into Japan, but into the United States, where they get more money after 1 year. So in order for investors to not kind of all invest into just one country, in order for there to be sort of a balance in the investments made in this world, we must have this, you know, condition that the 1 year forward rate between two specific countries should be calculated, you know, the way we did it in this example. And the actual forward rate should exactly match this calculated number to prevent the covered interest arbitrage opportunity.